And we are live. Now, the private chauffeur, limo driver, private driver, whatever you want to be titled, right? The course at Gig Rocket, and the link is going to be below, teaches you everything my channel is about. So there are two things that are very dear to me in my channel. The one is safety for drivers, right? Safety for any driver worldwide, whether you are a rideshare driver, limo driver, bus driver, I don't care. The companies owe you their duty to keep you safe, right? Because you're doing a massive job on the road. And if they can improve the app, whatever they can do to make your life safer, that is what they need to focus on. The other one is obviously, how do I get into the business? How can I maximize my earnings? How can I climb the ladder? How can I really awaken my entrepreneurial spirit, right? Make the real money. And if you have dibbled and dabbled, if you are a beginner, if you are a veteran in the rideshare business, if you are a taxi driver, I highly encourage you to step it up, right? And this course is not really for individuals that don't like any risk at all, right? There's very minimal risk involved in this, but if you are a person that's just all about, you know, grinding away, doing your hours, low risk or no risk, then this is definitely not for you. But if you really want to go out there and maximize your earnings, and you have already taken that step to buy a nice sedan or a luxury vehicle, a Mercedes or a BMW or a Range Rover or any one of the big SUVs, a Cadillac or a Suburban or a Yukon, right? Or a Metris, or even, you know, like a nice Toyota Sienna, maybe black on black, then this is for you, right? Because the one thing is, having spoken to thousands and thousands of rideshare drivers on the Uber and Lyft platform and other platforms, they understand the game, right? They understand what is needed from them, right? They have been out there, they've pushed the hard hours. Some people do 10, 12 hours. And at the end of the day, you calculate, hey, what did I make on this Monday or this Saturday? How many hours did I put in? And is this making sense? If it is not making sense, if you see your earnings diminishing, right, you really have to start thinking in this direction. And that is, hey, I made this massive investment into a car. I got to make it work. So going through the curriculum, right? And by the way, here you are your own boss. This is the ultimate pinnacle of independent contractor, right? The companies like to term you or give you that brand independent contractor, but really under Uber and Lyft, you're probably about 30 to 40% true independent contractor. As a private driver, as a limo driver, chauffeur, it has different titles worldwide. And this course is aimed at any city, whether it's New York, Chicago, Los Angeles, Miami, Salt Lake City, London, Cape Town, Johannesburg, Tokyo, Birmingham, Toronto, Vancouver, Rio de Janeiro, any big city, you can be a private driver and tap into crazy cool clientele, right? If you guys would see the list of names of my clientele, over 300 to date, right? I get an average of about 4 to 5 bookings a day, private bookings. I turn away a lot of my bookings. I give them to my other drivers in my fleet, right? I personally can't, I don't turn them away and say, hey, I cannot service you, right? But I will have one of my backup drivers drive you. And I have arrangements with my backup driver. If I send them a $200 booking, I get 20%, right? That's a lot. That's $40. I may not be able to do it at that hour because I'm taking care of other clients. But if I have a double or a triple booking, I'm making money from other drivers. So all of this is explained in the course, right? The main thing is, as you go through this, and I do consider myself a veteran, and I can boast with the names that I have attracted from NBA players, NFL players, Hollywood actors, Hollywood actresses, CEOs, big names, musicians, rap stars, famous rock bands, you name it. Families, the kids of these wealthy individuals, billionaires. I probably have about 4 billionaires in my portfolio, driven all the who's who in LA. Now, LA is a great city. A lot of big names, people coming in and out. Two major airports, Los Angeles and Burbank, which will be about 80% of your bookings. And in any big metropolitan city or so, it'll usually be airport bookings, hotel pickups, concerts, events, basketball games, football games, you name it. This is where these type of people like to go to. Business meetings, business trips. And what's important here, explained in the course, and they are, it's a 300-minute course. It's $69. If you use the discount code HELP20, H-E-L-P-2-0, you get a further 20% off, right? And that's basically a gift, because the money really is already in the first module named Marketing, Referrals, and Networking. Now, there are over 22 modules, 300 minutes. In this first one, probably the most important one, how do I market myself? How do I connect with these type of clients? I go through everything. I tell you exactly where to meet them, where to find them, how to get them, how to convert them, and how to, more importantly, how to nurture and keep them, right? You don't want to just a once-off client. You want repeat, repeat, repeat bookings. I have clients sending me the bookings all the way into 2023, mid-July 2023, right? I can plan in advance. I know exactly on what given day. I know what I'm, who I'm driving tomorrow, where I'm picking them up, where I'm taking them, what I'm making, right? And by the way, the most, or the coolest thing about this compared to Uber and Lyft, is that 100% of these earnings are going into your own pockets, right? You are not splitting this 40% you, 60% Uber or Lyft, or 50-50. No, 100% goes to you. And yes, your overheads become higher. Look, your vehicle cost, your insurance, your gas always stays the same. But the only thing that will take a jump up is basically the commercial insurance. So how to price trips, right? You get very good data and feedback from Uber and Lyft as to the pricing. How can I price my trips that I keep the client happy and that I make the maximum returns? How do I schedule these? Cheeky Chops is in the house, Kaapstad. A shout out to Cape Town. Good to see you. So how do I schedule these trips, right? And you can't overschedule, and you can't make them too tight, meaning you can't have a drop off and a pickup just minutes apart. It's not going to work. If a plane comes in early, if a plane comes in late, you're screwed. You have to learn how to create these buffer zones, all explained in scheduling. How do I do my taxes? You are a business, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, you have a small risk attached to this, but you are now a business. You set yourself up as an LLC or S Corp, and you write off all your taxes, explained. The application process and licensing. I give several examples of big cities. The application process and licensing differs from city to city. It is not expensive. It's just a bunch of paperwork. And it usually takes anywhere from about a week to 3 months to the max, right? And this goes for the application process and licensing in the United States, in Europe, in Asia. We talk about all of those things. Now, VIPs, very important people, right? How to handle them, how to keep them, right? There's a certain way you interact. There's a certain, Cape Flats is in the house. That, by the way, I used to have a business there in the Cape Flats. I used to have a lot of little mini casinos, so I know that area well. The VIPs, how to handle them, we go into great length. How to handle the executive and corporate transport. If you want, multiple clients, if you want to get corporate accounts, that is explained in great detail. How do I do parties and events? Now, parties and events, usually big crowds, a lot of alcohol, usually the most stressful trips, right? Organizing and driving people for parties, events, weddings, etc. Usually quiet as you go there, and extremely loud and wild when you leave and go back. Mario Sadia is in the house. I'm giving people shout outs as I'm talking about this. Now, airports and private jets, the large airports like Los Angeles, Airport LAX, obviously in LA, are very different to the little private airports around Van Nuys, Burbank, JetSuite X, NetJets, right? There will always be, if you're in a city like Scottsdale or New York, every major city has the big airports and the private airports. Explained in great detail how to handle both. Hotels, knowing your hotels, your five-star hotels in your city can make you a lot of money. Expand can also bring you a ton of business. Explained. The nightlife. If you are taking a group of kids like I am tomorrow, clubbing, right? You got to keep them together. You got to be a master of communication and texting and interacting with parents or picking elderly up, over 21 at clubs, etc. You got to know how to handle it. Explained here. Restaurants, knowing the high-end restaurants in your city. For example, Nobu down in Malibu in my city. I can pick up a ton of clients there. I can recruit a lot of A-list clients. You got to know where and how. Explained here. Choosing the right vehicle. The right vehicle for the right city. In a city like mine, you will see a lot of SUVs. You will see a lot of Cadillacs and Suburbans. Almost as many as sedans. Big crowds mean big money. Some cities, especially European cities, it's more the sedans. We go into that, choosing the right vehicle. The dress code and etiquette, you always have to look good. You don't have to have a suit and tie each time. A jacket is nice. Dress code is important. Smelling good is important. Being clean, shaven, ready for work. People appreciate that, right? Staging your vehicle. How do I set up my vehicle for this type of clientele, right? Do I pick Evian waters or Fiji waters? Do I have mints on board? What type of magazines? We talk about that in great detail. Right now, qualities of a private driver. I would just say there are at least 10 to 15 qualities. Excuse me. There are many qualities you should bring to this job. Punctual, reliability, just a couple of the key factors, right? Santiago, thank you, said bless you. I appreciate that. Mary Varallo said bless you. Man, it's the wind. It's the Santa Ana's here again. So the next one is integrating another job or business. Big one. For example, if you are a realtor, if you are a notary, especially a realtor, right, a broker or a realtor, you're in real estate, you can make so much money. The amount of homes that I have sold through my car, with home magazines, with my business cards, as a real estate agent, showing people around. A, they're your client, and then when it comes to home buying, they know that you're a realtor. Now you take them home shopping, right? Whether they're selling a house or buying a house. So you can integrate other businesses so easily with this, right? Transportation of children and teenagers. Tomorrow I have a group of 7 kids for 5 to 6 hours, multiple stops. How do you handle that? How do you communicate with the parents? What makes you a professional driver when it comes to kids and interfacing with the parents? I'm driving a bunch of 14, 15, 16-year-olds that don't have licenses, right? I got to be on the ball. Usually loud music, people everywhere. You got to round them up. You got to communicate with the parents. We explain that in great detail, right? Handling the luggage, right? You should always handle the luggage for them, whether you're picking up at the airport, dropping off at the hotels. This is very, very important. So again, also next one, who is your backup driver? Who is your backup driver, right? So if you have a double booking or a triple booking, you got to pass that person on to one of your backup drivers. In my fleet, I have multiple backup drivers. The course, by the way, also includes the fleet course, which is actually $69, but is offered free of charge along with this course, right? If you want to build out a fleet of cars. So if you don't want to be a one-man show, if you want to have 5 cars, 10 cars, 15 cars or more, I show you exactly how that's done. Then you always pick from your very, very best drivers. in that fleet of cars, who do I use to service my clients if I cannot drive them, right? So who is your backup driver? We went through that in great detail. Safety, obviously a big one. You got to keep all your clients safe. You can't necessarily drive through crazy areas. Safety is key, especially when people have been drinking, right? Got to keep them safe. So yeah, check that out. So the person just said, I own multiple rental properties. The return of investment in this business as a fleet, I have rental properties, is far higher. You'll make far more money with fleets than rental homes. I'll guarantee you that. Been there, done that. So check that out. You also get your certification once you've completed the course. This is ideal for 22 to 75-year-olds. This business, right? Got Florida in the house, and Kevin's in the house. It's a lot of people coming in and out. Hit the like button. So if you are 25 to 75 years old, I'm not sure what Follow Your Lead says. Will you sell your dress code? I don't know exactly what you're saying there, but okay. So income, minimum, once you have your clients and you're on a roll and you're getting referrals, you're talking anywhere minimum $300-$400 a day, right up to $2,500 a day. Today for me is a $500 day. Tomorrow, Saturday, for me is a $1,400 day, right? So all depends what type of bookings you have, what time of the week it is. Obviously, weekends are pretty busy. You know, are you taking them on wine tours? Are you doing a little bit of showing them around the city, acting as their tour guide? You can charge for all these add-ons. Everything is explained in the course. Now, the link will be below. Really focus on the first one, because marketing referrals and networking is where it is at. If you're a quiet, introverted person, this business is not for you. If you are an outgoing, personal, approachable, networking type of person, you will grow this so quickly. Business cards is one. Now, another great tip, some people say, hey, this is not really the way to go. Most of my clients I've taken from Uber and Lyft. Look, you have to take care of yourself. If the companies are not taking care of yourself, you take care of their clients. Riders and passengers on the Uber and Lyft platform, especially Lyft Lux, Uber Black, Uber SUV, Lyft SUV, even XL, Uber XL and Lyft XL, they are sick and tired of the astronomic rates. If, for example, here Calabasas to the airport, Uber Black would charge $260, $270. I can do that trip all day long and get that client by saying, listen, I can do that trip for you for $200. You get a clean car, car looks great, smells great. You get a reliable driver showing up at the right time, whether it's 4:30 a.m., 5 a.m., 2 in the afternoon, 12 o'clock at night, I will pick you up, right? And if they know, even if the rich people know, that they are saving $50 to $60 on each trip, right, versus Uber and Lyft, which are sky high at the moment, they will drive with you all day long. They will not go back on the Uber and Lyft platform. So I highly encourage drivers that are on the Uber and Lyft platform, have the right car, or are about to buy the right car for this type of business, make sure you know how to do your soft sale, get riders, passengers from Uber and Lyft, and convert them over to the private business of yours, right? You'll make a lot more money than splitting it 50-50 or 40-60 with Uber and Lyft, right? So run this as a business. We show you everything. We show how to price these trips. Showing them some savings is great, right? If you have a $200 trip and you with Uber and you have to share that 50-50, you're making $100, right? And the client's still going to pay $200. If you can offer that same trip at $180, right, you are making bank, right? You are making the 100 that Uber would have given you plus an additional 80. You don't have to charge the 200 like Uber and Lyft do. So we go into great length explaining everything. Now, Uber and Lyft are worldwide. At least Lyft is in Canada, but Uber is worldwide. Whether you are in Paris, whether you are in Berlin, whether you are in Amsterdam, you know, wherever you are in Europe, wherever you are in the United States, you can start this business. Wherever you are in Canada or South America or the Arab Emirates or Dubai, whatever city you're in, you can become a private driver, private chauffeur. London drivers, I mean, some of the top private chauffeurs in the world, really, really good quality service, right? You want to offer platinum service. I teach you this, how to talk to the people, how to treat them well, what to do, how to keep them, how to sell yourself to these individuals. Many of my clients I've driven for 7 or 8 years. They're not going away because they know consistently what they get. They're getting a reliable driver who shows up on time, gives them a decent rate, doesn't rob them like Uber and Lyft, and takes care of the client. So that is what I teach you. You're going to get the very, very best here in these 300 minutes, in these 5 hours, 22 modules. We've gone through them. The link is below. Please use code HELP, HELP20, HELP20 for a 20% discount. The link is right underneath the video. And just here, a collage of a few of the people I drive. You may recognize this individual over here, Jamie Foxx. That's French Fontana. That's some of the top boxes. I just threw a few here together. That's David Hasselhoff. This is Stephen Irwin's kids, Khalid, musicians, actresses, country singers, models, basketball stars, you name them, right? I will show you how to get them. So drive safe, everyone. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment box below. Smash the like button and please step it up, right? If you're sick and tired of the poor earnings you're getting from Uber and Lyft and you already have a vehicle, you really need to go in this direction. You want to be on three platforms at the end of the day as a US driver, on Uber, Lyft, and you want your private clients. So Roulette Wheel says Uber stopped showing what the customer pays for each ride, so that's shady. Very shady, right? You gotta always, your client always needs to know, hey, I'm charging you this. You gotta be transparent, black and white. This nonsense that Uber and Lyft does is just robbing you of cash every single day, right? So check it out. Again, if you have any questions on the private chauffeur, limo driver, private driver, driver for hire course, reach out to me. I'll gladly answer. Again, it's $69. With the 20% discount, it's only $55. Leave your comments, please, and have a great day. Thank you so much, everyone. Be well. God bless, wherever you are.